smiles. Now, did Toronto get outshot? Ridiculous. Yeah. Did Joseph Wall look amazing? Yeah. Did Toronto sit Mitch Marner and Auston Matthews and had Connor Timmins play forward? Yeah. Did Tampa Bay play their entire playoff lineup? Yes. Did we see Brian Elliott in net to counter Joseph Wall and the E-Bug sitting there on the bench? No, we had Andre Vasilevskiy. Did we have, you know, Cirelli going up against Auston Matthews? No. You had Braden Point up there. You had Kucherov. You had Stamkos. You had the whole bloody Bolts lineup ready for the playoffs. Dickhead Patrick Maroon and Corey Perry included. And they still lost to the Toronto Maple Leafs, who had a rookie in Matthew Nyes, his second game back into the arena where he lost his NCAA finals as a counter to their first line. Yes, that's Matthew Nyes playing first line with Ryan O'Reilly and Nylander, and then it went all mixed up because Leafs went 7D. Yes, we're on our commute, our morning commute to daycare, nursery. We get to talk about the Leafs winning 4-3. I would have done this last night, but I pulled what a typical dad would do, and I watched the game, and then proceeded to fall asleep on the couch, so I didn't record after the game. Toronto wins 4-3, Joseph Wall played amazing, and you're like, Samsonov's phenomenal, and having Joseph Wall as his backup, can't complain, that's a future duo there, and we have Samsonov still an RFA. Wall, can't send him down next year because we're definitely going to lose him. But yeah, just Wall played phenomenal, 40 something saves, and Leafs win. Let's talk about the start of the game. At first I thought the game was going to be very relaxed. Both teams don't want to get injured. It was like a meaningless game, as meaningless as it could be. Tampa Bay looks like they've been playing meaningless games ever since they realized that, well, we're playing Toronto. Which feels like, I think it was pretty much like etched in stone since November. But when they realize, oh, okay, no one else in our division is going to be able to catch us, we can just relax now and we'll get ready. We'll turn up for the playoffs, which is what they will do. But like Leafs have 109 points now and Tampa Bay has 96, I think. Ridiculous. Anyway, Toronto scores first, and it's William Nylander, who has like 7 goals in his last 8 games against Tampa Bay. Love it. Caught Vasilevskiy cheating there. The 5-hole was open. Sure, it hit off the toe of his stick, but he was shooting for the 5-hole. He was shooting there. Made it 1-0. Tampa Bay ties it up, and to be fair, it was a good goal. Good goal. Then Tampa Bay scores again, and it's Patrick Maroon scoring, but I think it was Corey Perry. Makes a home for himself in the crease. Skating away. Joseph Wall can't push across. Of course, it's no goal. Bolts fans booing. If it happened to the Leafs and it was in Toronto, the Leafs fans would be booing as well, but even if it was against Toronto, that was technically goaltender interference. The funniest thing is Luke Shen then comes down and scores his first goal in like, I forget how many days they said. It was a sniper and like a knuckler top corner. It was lit right after to make it 2-1. And then he body checks Maroon, and Maroon wants to fight. Shen goes, yeah, I'll freaking fight you. And then I'll manhandle you to the ground and throw you down. And that was awesome. And I was like, God, I love Luke Shen even more. Is it even possible? That makes it 2-1. Tampa Bay does score in the second period to make it 2-2. And it was, came out to, I don't even know the defenseman's name. He's a righty. It was a nice shot over the left pad, under the left glove. Obviously left glove, he only has one glove, Dan. There was a goal, a little bit of a scramble for the Leafs. There's a few times there was scrambles tonight. And It cost the Leafs there. Anyway, it makes it 2-2. That's okay. Toronto makes it 3-2 on the power play when, again, booing. But, one, if you cross-check someone on your stick breaks, that's a penalty. Two, the refs actually called the shenanigans after the whistle. After the whistle, Kucherov freaking sticks his foot out. Trips Brody. Numpty. What a knobhead. And then, I don't even know what the guy's name is. I think it starts with an E. He comes in. Whistle's gone. He comes in and bumps another Leaf. Well, now you're just trying to start shit. Go to the box. Good. Toronto gets it. It's a 4-on-3. Nylander's up top. They're going 4 forwards. Nylander, O'Reilly, Tavares, Yarncroke. Yarny's back. Nylander puts it on for Tavares' tip. Of course, tips it. Gets stuck in his feet. That's okay. Tavares finds it. Taps it over to Yarncroke. Yarncroke roofs it. His 20th of the year. Yes, what a steal. At first, at the beginning, you're like, that's a lot of money for Yarncroke. Now you're like, ooh, that's a good deal for Yarncroke. He gets his 20th of the year. Welcome back, Yarny. Next to just Lafferty because he's still injured. So Leafs are up 3-2. Go into the third period. Oh, shoot, no. We got to talk about Perry and Bunting fighting. Perry cross-checks the shit out of Michael Bunting. Michael definitely does a little roll there. Yeah, maybe some embellishment there. A little bit. But at the same time, you're going full speed and you got cross-checked. So lower back. So Bunting goes, fakes like he's going to Jordan Binnington it. Like, you know, like the fake punch, but like the fake Donald Brashear. Says, ah, screw it, let's just fight you in front of the bench. He's fighting Corey in front of the bench. You can tell the Leafs are like, ooh, do we just give him an extra little shot there? No penalty for Perry on the cross check. They just both go for fighting, so that was weird. later on, in the third, it was in the second period again, actually. John Tavares, might have been the third, John Tavares got like, I don't know, swarmed by 3 bolts. And Bunting goes in to protect his captain. And Bunting's the only one who gets a penalty. The Michael Bunting bias is... it's real. Come on. It's real. But at the same time, I'm okay with it. Because even though the refs were inconsistent, they tried to stop the shit. And they penalized the teams accordingly, or for what they felt like trying to initiate the extra stuff. So I'm okay with it. I think it was like they felt with the Bunting thing that Tavares, yeah, he got swarmed, but nothing was really happening. Then Bunting made it go over the top. Whatever. You called Kucherov on his shenanigans. You called the other dude. I'm fine with it. Okay, but let's just keep that. Like, if someone comes in and starts shit after the whistle, just put him in the box for unsportsmanlike conduct or something. For Kucherov, it could have been a whole slew of things. Trying to slew foot. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Tripping. Throw the book at him. It doesn't matter. Just put him in the box and hopefully that stops it so we don't get it. Because I thought it was going to be a tame game and then I shouldn't have thought that. So yeah, there's the Bunting fight and all that other stuff. But then we go to the third period, and Nylander strips the puck from Hedman, which you don't hear often, feeds Matthew Nyes, he beats Vasilevskiy, it's going to stop on the goal line, Ryan O'Reilly's there to pop it in, and it is 4-2 Leafs. Tempe does make it 4-3 on a TJ Brody turnover. There was a few of those tonight. They like to do that bump to the middle. Scary. It goes to Sergachev, who has become an absolute stud. We saw it last year, and he's now become their number one defenseman. He's the guy that they want Hedman to play with. So, yeah, Sergachev snipes, and then it's the Joseph Wall show mixed with the Toronto Maple Leafs just blocking everything. McCabe's there. Everyone just sacrificing the body. They're in playoff mindset, not past year playoff mindset. This is a stronger team this year. Joseph Wall was phenomenal, so you know if anything happens for Samsonov, we have him there. He is the future of the Toronto Maple Leafs with Sammy. Leafs win 4-3. It's a big F you to Kucherov, who I just despise. He's such a... that's it. That's like, I can't... There's no even words. He's just an... unlikable. Let's just say that. A lot of Tampa is unlikable. I do not like Tampa. Do you like Tampa, Rem? That's him saying... No. They suck. Leafs win 4-3. And they beat Tampa Bay with a scattered lineup. Connor Timmins, remember, played forward. There was no Auston Matthews or Mitch Marner. What I do like is that fan who said, I came all this way from Toronto to watch Mitch Marner and Auston Matthews. Well, you didn't get to do that, but he got to meet them after the game, pictures and all that, so that's cool. Leafs win, 4-3. One more game to go against Detroit. A little tune-up and then probably a couple days rest. And the playoffs begin. So, comment down your thoughts of the game. For me, Toronto got, like, doubled up in shots. Expected. Look at the lineup. Right? Kucherov had, like, 10 shots himself. But Tampa Bay couldn't score on the power play. They were 0-for-8. And Joseph Woll shut the door when it mattered most. Toronto hunkered down. They kept that lead. I love it. What a great Tuesday night when a back-to-back and beating Florida, then Tampa Bay. You gotta love it. Anyway, comment down below your thoughts on the game. Take care, everyone. Have a good week. Go Leafs, go.